for some of us out there, whether it is the solar eclipse or the lunar eclipse, it tends to kind of jar our nerves. But for me, it actually becomes a task which is more fulfilling, because I go totally passionately when these eclipses are taking place. Now, on July 27th, we have a total lunar eclipse. Now, let me repeat the entire thing for you. July 10th, Jupiter went direct. It helps us to use our intelligence in whichever way we can. And it helps us to construct. It helps us to expand. It helps us to focus and concentrate intelligently on what we want to. Then we confront the solar eclipse, which is the partial solar eclipse. It helps us to know and create our own identity. Then we come to July 26th, when Mercury goes retrograde, which again wants us to introspect our communications, or it wants us to introspect that when we come in, when we confront a group of people, or when we confront our working class, or when we confront people in general, what is the kind of impact that we have on people? Are we known as extrovert or are we known as introvert? How do we need to balance our extrovertness, or sometimes an introvert tends to behave more extrovertly? That also can send mixed signals. So it helps us to analyze. Now, of all the things, when we culminate our intelligence and our communication skills, is our impact of emotions. Total lunar eclipse brings us face to face with our emotions. Are our emotions balanced? Are we getting the kind of things that we feel we are deserving? Are we emotionally very fragile, or are we emotionally strong? So we are actually battling with the surge of emotions that are wanting to flee from our heart. But if I have actually introspected that, what are my communication skills? Why are my relationships going wrong? Am I sending mixed signals? Trust me, you'll be able to handle these total lunar eclipses, which are impacting our emotions, much more fluently and much more successfully. So the partial solar eclipse has helped to identify our status and our identity in front of the world. Mercury retrograde has helped us to identify where our communications are going right or wrong and how to rectify that. A combination of the recognition of our identity and our communication skills can help us become emotionally very strong, can help us come face to face, why are my emotions being so turbulent? So rather than being a victim of circumstances, you need to get up and be a controller of your life, handle your emotions well, and learn to know that analyzing my emotions, self-respecting my own self, and building the self-confidence by being a self-motivator is what will help you sail across all these eclipses much more successfully and much more positively than rather getting down and feeling so upset. They say in life, problems are always there. You need to face them. And when problems are there, your first reaction should be that, how do I absolve myself of it? How do I observe this and rectify myself? So mentally, when you become strong, your physical aspects become strong again. So a healthy mind in a healthy body. So during the lunar eclipse, your exercise is must. You need to build your emotions much more strongly. You don't have to cower down and become a victim and wallow in self-pity that your emotions are surging so badly. If you are, you may come face to face during the lunar eclipse and realize that your relationship is not going strong. So what you need to do about it is address those emotions. Is it not going strong because of some deficiency on your part? Which is not a crime, just recognizing. And also that will help you analyze and realize whether your energies are in tune or sync with your partner or not. or whether in your working area you are able to build up strongly the teamwork or not. Are you able to address the situations? Because anybody who's emotionally strong inside, actually you can make your world a beautiful place, especially with your strength of mind, your strength of character, and your strength of well-being. So total lunar eclipse has not to be feared. It is just a way to make you feel that you need to address and correct the incorrect.